Hi, I'm Joe Todd. I'm going to show you the new bar graph capability of our Spark Science software. It's a great new feature that allows you to make bar graphs, collecting data that doesn't require time, either with a sensor or without a sensor. So the flexibility you're going to find really, really helpful as a teacher. This video focuses on the ability to collect data with a sensor and put it into a bar graph. The other video shows you how to make a bar graph without using sensors. Today I'm going to be using a tablet, in this case SparkVue HD, which is used on the iPad and also on many Android devices that you find in the classroom. Well, first I have to link my sensor. So to do that, I go to Settings. And once I do that, you'll see that there's an AirLink, and I identify it by the number on the back. So if you have a class full of these, this is the AirLink 2. And on the back of it, there's a series of numbers, and that helps the students to know which one they're supposed to connect to. So I'm connecting to this one now. And once I'm connected, I'm going to plug in my sensor, and then I'm going to open SparkVue HD so we can start collecting data. I'm using a non-contact temp sensor today, and this is a neat one. It allows you to detect the temperature of a surface just by aiming at it. So I used it earlier today to take the temperature of different surfaces that were sunny and shady, and we'll take a look at that in a little bit. But let me show you how to build a bar graph with it first. So to do this, I'm going to go under Build, and on the Build screen, I select Temperature, and you can see there's a number of other readings too. Based upon the tablet, it has all these built-in sensors, and so you can actually build graphs with those sensors, but we're going to use a non-contact temp sensor for this one. Then I need to select bar graphs, so you can see the icon there on the right-hand side about three down. So once that is selected, I press OK, and then we're ready to start collecting data. Now I can go ahead and press Go and start sampling data, but it's a good idea to label your axes, because you can see on the right-hand side I have an x-axis variable, and that doesn't mean much. On the right-hand side, I do have, for the y-axis, I have temperature, and that's great because that's what this is. But we need to know what is our independent variable. So to do that, I'm going to, on the lower right-hand side, there's a tool called the bar graph properties tool. And I'm going to change the x-axis variable to something a little more meaningful. So I press on the x-axis variable. And when I do that, I can now create a data set. And then I'm going to name it. So I press in there, and then a keyboard shows up for me. In this case, we just have different surfaces that we're going to measure the temperature of. Okay. To start naming the bars, I'm going to use this tool called the Bar Add and Edit tool. It's in the upper left-hand corner of the tool palette. Once it's on, you can see a gray bar shows up with the label of bar 1. When I press on the bar, a menu shows up. And in this case, I can change the bar name. I press on where it says bar 1, and I'm going to backspace that out, and I'm going to name this, in this case, I'm going to measure the table to start. I press OK, and then another bar shows up. The Bar Add and Edit tool already throws in a new one, inviting your students to go ahead and to name that bar as well. So this bar 2, in this case, I have a hot plate, and we'll measure the surface temperature of it as well. And then finally, I have a beaker of ice, and so I want to measure its temperature, so I press on the bar again, replace it with the appropriate title, say OK, and then it can go on and on and on. But I'm just measuring three surfaces this time. So I'm going to turn off the Bar Add and Edit tool, and I'm ready to start collecting data. To start collecting data, using manual sampling, I'm going to press the play button in the lower left corner. So I press Go, and you'll notice that it starts a live feed of the temperature. So I'm going to hold it up, oh, just a little over a foot or so, and when I'm happy with the value, I see that it's pretty stable, I'm going to press the check in the lower left-hand corner, and then that records the value. You'll notice that the bar immediately changes to a color. And that's a sign to the students that they have both the independent and the dependent variables for that bar set. They have a name for the bar. They also have a value for the bar, so it gives them a color indicating that it has a complete data set. Now, the hot plate. I'm going to turn on another tool for us that I think is pretty interesting. In the tool palette, The third one down from the right-hand side is a bar value tool. What this does is it reveals what the temperature is, the values, the numbers, above the bar. And that's kind of helpful for students to see what's actually going on besides the bar going up and down. I'm going to hold the non-contact temp sensor above the hot plate, about the same height, about a foot above there. Press go. And I have an idea about what the temperature is of that surface. And then finally, let's go above ice and see what happens. And you can see, again, the temperature drops about a foot above that. And I'm going to press check when that about stabilizes, just to sample the data from these different surfaces. So that gives you an idea about how to build a bar graph with a sensor and how to collect data. Now I want to show you some other data where we can analyze it a little bit, show you some of the tools. So I'm going to open a lab that I took earlier, taking some data from outside, looking at surfaces that were in the sun and surfaces that were in the dark. So what you see here is we have data showing grass, concrete, and the asphalt when it was in the sun versus when it was in the shade. You can use this software with any time that you're going to be collecting data at specific points, like maybe dissolved oxygen at different points along a stream, or the light level below trees in a forest. Very, very helpful for discrete data. So this data, I'm going to analyze it a little bit. And so on the lower, in the middle lower left side there, there's an icon called the statistics tool. And so when I press it, I can open up different statistics that I might be interested in seeing. I can get a minimum value, I can find a maximum value for the bars, a mean, and then if standard deviation is important, I could select that as well. Press OK, and then you can see that it throws the values of each bar, the mean, the maximum up top, the minimum down below, giving students just very quickly just the mathematical analysis of these bars. So that gives you an idea about how to collect data using a sensor. For more on the bar graph, on how to set it up without a sensor, and maybe an idea that you can use with your students, be sure to see the other video. And if you're interested in Spark Science software, check out more information at pasco.com. And if you'd like to get SparkVue HD for your tablet, you can get that at the App Store.